you love Jesus, say amen. I want you to get your Bibles out with me this morning, and I want you to go with me to the book of Exodus. Hallelujah to God. Exodus, just pick a chapter and verse. We're going to be all over the place. Hallelujah. Yeah. Exodus chapter 14. And we came to get something from the Lord today. Yeah. Hallelujah to God. Exodus chapter 14. If you didn't bring a Bible, all you got to do is look right up behind me. And I believe that you'll be blessed. The Word of God will be there in the name of Jesus. I am on some kind of a campaign, I believe. I'm on a soapbox. The reason why is because I visit with so many people, go to so many hospitals, have to talk to so many people on a constant basis. And people call me. They want me to go see their friends or their relatives in the hospital. They want me to, you know, to minister to so many people. And without question, in the church and then outside the church, I can literally minister to way over 1,000 people a month with all the things that we do, all the people that we're in contact with or call us on the telephone, all kinds of things. And what is amazing to me is how many people have been misled about what the Lord can do.
Right.
Yes. Is anybody in this place?
Yeah.
How many people are misled that the Lord uses the devil to teach us something, that the Lord uses sickness and disease to train us? When he said himself, I'm going to send you another comforter, and he'll guide you into all truth, and he'll show you things to come. How many know you got another teacher?
Yes.
And that's the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. His word is a lamp to my... God doesn't use the devil for nothing. The Bible says for this purpose, the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the work of the devil. Can I get a witness in this place? To destroy the work of the devil. He doesn't use sickness. He doesn't use disease to teach you something, to humiliate you or humble you. The Bible says he took our infirmities. He bore our sicknesses. And by his stripes we are healed. It would be crazy for Jesus to bear stripes to heal me and then to use sickness to do something about me. Can I get a witness in those places? It's absolutely crazy. It's our fault when we get into that mistake. It's our fault when we get into that mess. And so I want to take some things from the Word of God. I'm going to preach on the power of Jesus' blood today. Thank God for the blood. Thank God for the blood. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Amen. Jesus paid it all. All to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, but he washed me white as snow. How many believe it? Say amen. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins. Anybody, any sinner can plunge beneath that flood and lose all their guilty stain. Have you believe it with me? Say amen. Hallelujah. I need thee, oh, I need thee every hour. I need thee, oh, cleanse me now. My Savior, I come to thee. Can I get a witness? Exodus chapter 14. Exodus chapter 14. Hallelujah. I'm going to begin reading, if you want to be there with me, in the first verse, Exodus chapter 14, verse number 1. If you're there, say amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. If you're not, say oh me. Verse 1, the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel that they turn and encamp by Pihahiroth between Migdol and the sea over against Baal-Zephon. Before it you shall encamp by the sea. For Pharaoh will say of the children of Israel, they are entangled in the land. The wilderness has shut them up. And I will harden Pharaoh's heart. He shall follow after them. I will be honored upon Pharaoh and upon all of his host, that the Egyptians may know that I am the Lord. And they did what the Lord said they would do. And it was told the king of Egypt that the people fled. And the heart of Pharaoh and of his servants was turned against the people. And they said, why have we done this, that we have let Israel go from serving us? And he made ready his chariot and took his people with him. And he took 600 chosen chariots and all the chariots of Egypt and captains over every one of them. And the Lord hardened the heart of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. And he pursued after the children of Israel. And the children of Israel went out with a high hand. Verse 9. But the Egyptians pursued after them all the horses and chariots of Pharaoh and his horsemen and his army, and overtook Israel encamping beside the sea, beside Pi-ha-ha-roth. I'd be glad I could say that. Say amen. Before Beelzebub. Verse 10. And when Pharaoh drew near, everybody say, that's the past.
That's the past.
Say that again. That's the past. Look at your neighbor and tell him, that's your past trying to come back.
Trying to.
Anybody listening to me?
Yeah.
And when Pharaoh drew near, the children of Israel lifted up their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians marched after them, and they became afraid. And the children of Israel cried unto the Lord. And they said to Moses, because there is no graves in Egypt, you have brought us out here to die. If you underline in your Bible so you have a piece of paper, write down the words, brought us out here to die. A lot of times when I'm ministering to people, they think that the Lord brought them out here to die. Are you with me?
Yeah.
They have brought us away to die in the wilderness. Wherefore hast thou dealt with us like this to carry us forth out of Egypt? Is not this the word that we did tell you in Egypt, saying, leave us alone?
Yeah.
That we may serve the Egyptians, for it had been better for us to serve the Egyptians than we should die out here. That we should die in this wilderness. Verse 13. Moses said unto the people, fear not. Stand still. Somebody tell Moses to shut up. I know you don't believe it yet, but this was not a word from God. Moses said, fear not, stand still. See the salvation of the Lord that the Lord will show you today. From the Egyptians you've seen today, you will see them again forever, no more. Part of it was God, part of it was not. Look at verse 14. The Lord shall fight for you. You shall hold your peace. And the Lord said unto Moses, why are you crying to me? Speak to the children of Israel and tell them to get moving.
Yeah. 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 Amen.
Moses telling them to stand still, and God's telling them to get moving.
Get moving. Get moving. That's good.
Anybody going to talk to me?
Yeah. Get moving.
Moses telling them to stand still. God telling them to get moving. Moses telling them just to stay right here. Just to be quiet. Just to be quiet and stay right here. When you really need to get up and praise and get moving.
Hallelujah.
You need to get up and shout and get moving. You need to get up your voice and say, Lord, oh, look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me. Just in time, don't you tell me to stand here and stay still and be quiet. Look what the Lord has done. Anybody in this place, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. I want you to just give me a few minutes this morning, because I want to minister something to you out of Exodus chapter 12. We don't have time to turn there. God tells Moses to tell the children of Israel, there's going to come a day very quickly, 4 days from now, and I'm going to deliver my people out of Egypt's bondage. Here's how I'm going to do it. I want them to go find a lamb. I want them to find a one-year-old lamb. I want it to be a spotless lamb. I don't want there to be any blemishes on that lamb. How does God, what's happening here? That God wanted people in bondage to go out and find thousands of lambs. When God wants you to have a lamb, he will provide a lamb. God himself will provide himself a lamb. How do people in bondage get a lamb with no spot on it? A lamb with no blemish on it? Yes. How do people that don't own anything all of a sudden own a lamb? God wants you to have it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thousands others of them begin to march out into the mountains and the hills, and all of a sudden lambs just come from everywhere. Nobody noticed that 1 year earlier, all over Egypt, lambs were being born by the thousands, by the tens of thousands, by the hundreds of thousands. Lambs were being born without a spot, without a blemish, without a mark on them, so that God could use them. Could it be that right now your miracle is being worked out by God?
Hallelujah.
Could it be that even a year, even 1 year before you did God's doing?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Can I get a witness in this
Amen.
Life?
Amen.
That even a year before you meet God's birthing your miracle. That a year before you ever had. Could I back up a little bit? Could it be that 2,000 years ago that your miracle was worked out?
Yeah.
2,000 years ago on a hill not very far away that your miracle was worked out. Could it be that you're looking for something now instead of you need to be looking back at 2,000 years? Hallelujah. Come on, can I get a witness?
Hallelujah.
Could it be the cross? Could it be the death and burial and resurrection of Jesus? Everything you need is there in those 3 days.
Hallelujah.
Everything you need is there. The preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness. But unto us that are saved,
Hallelujah.
It is the power.
The power.
It is the power.
The power.
Something right now, and he's already done it.
We've
got our binoculars looking out into the future. Where's my blessing? Where's my breakthrough? Where's my miracle? And I need to turn my binoculars around the other direction and get a fresh look at the crimson blood.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Is anybody in this place?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Can I get a witness in this place?
Yes.
I want you to take that lamb. I want you to save that lamb after you've had it for 4 days. I want you to take the blood of that lamb. I want you to mark your houses with that blood. After you mark your house with that blood, I want you to go into your bedroom. I want you to get your Nikes on.
Yeah.
I want you to get your running shoes on.
Yeah.
I want you to put your moving clothes on.
Yeah.
I want you to eat it in haste. I want you to eat it ready. I want you to put your coat on. I want you to put your gloves on. I want you to put your hat on.
Yeah.
Because in the morning you're coming out. In the morning you're getting out of this.
Hallelujah.
Rise and shine, for your light has come.
Yeah.
And the glory of the Lord is risen upon me. Come on, can I get a witness?
Yeah.
I want you to put everything on. I want you to be ready. Pack your bags. Get your car filled with gas. I want you to get everything ready, because in the morning you're moving out. You're moving ahead. You're moving forward. This can't hold you back no more. This can't get you down no more. This can't keep you in bondage no more. Because I want you to put the blood on it and get ready to go. A lot of our problems is that we're cropping about now instead of getting ready to go.
Yeah.
A lot of our problems we've got our eyes on right now, and we need to get ready to move out. Head them up.
Yeah.
Move them out. Head them up. Move them out. Come on, head them up.
Move them out.
Rolling, rolling, rolling. Keep them Christians going.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Anybody in this place? Come on, if I'm going to act a fool, act it with me now. Jesus knows, amen? Hallelujah. I want you to put that blood on it, but I want you to get ready. I want you to get dressed. I want you to get ready to move out. I want you to get ready. Could we have a service today? And we could put on a robe of righteousness.
Hallelujah.
We could put on the garment of praise.
Yes, yes,
we could put on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes, yes.
We could put on the oil of joy. Could we get ready and move out? Hallelujah. Come on, say amen.
Hallelujah.
I'm leaving that habit. I'm leaving that junk. I'm leaving my past. I'm leaving my sin. I'm leaving. Goodbye. Goodbye, world. Goodbye. Goodbye, world. Goodbye.
Goodbye,
sin. Goodbye.
Yeah.
Goodbye, devil. Goodbye. Goodbye,
goodbye.
Don't tell it, see you later. You ain't going to come back. Amen.
No. No.
Give the Lord a clapping shout of praise. I want you to be ready to go. I want you to be ready to move forward. Everybody say, move forward. If you study the story that I'm giving to you the next morning, all of a sudden those houses of bondage, those doors that stayed shut all night long while destruction came by, those doors that stayed shut all night long had an opening in the morning. There's a day. There is a day that this all will open up. There is a day. Come on, somebody say amen. They come out of that bondage and they're moving toward the promised land. All of a sudden they get to a particular place. And when they get to that Red Sea, I want you to listen to me now. When they get to the Red Sea and they see their past coming.
Come on.
When they get to the Red Sea and they see their past coming, they say something that is terrible. We need to be careful. Lord, you have brought us here to die. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Instead of saying, wait just a minute. Something died for me back in Egypt's bondage.
Yes.
Somebody died for me. Say it with me. Somebody died for me. That death was a lamb. The substitutionary death of a lamb. Can I invite you today to a fountain that is so sweet? Can I invite you to a lamb? Behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the whole world. God did not bring you here to die like that. God brought you here so that you would say this 2,000 years ago. Jesus Christ died for me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I prophesy over Tom's body now. I command his heart to be strengthened. I command his blood flow to become high. I command his blood pressure never to get out of bounds in his body in the name of Jesus Christ. I command his body to be renewed in the name of Jesus Christ. If there's something wrong in that heart, if there's some kind of heart disease in that heart, I rebuke it, Tom.
Hallelujah.
The pain that you've been with, in the name of Jesus, I command for your body to be healed. And you will be healed in Jesus' name. Years and years and years. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Here they are stuck in the Egyptians. Their past comes. And they say, what? We brought us out here to die. And here's what they should have done. They should have looked back to the house that they put blood on and said, somebody died for me. An innocent lamb died for me. I've still got my traveling forward clothes on. I've still got my travel. I still got the lamb in my belly. I still believe in that blood. Something died for me. All through their travels, they said, would to God we died in Israel. All through their travels, they said to God, you brought us here to die. You brought us here to die. Say it with me. You brought us here to die. That's what they had to conquer. They had to quit saying you brought us here to die and look back and say, somebody already died. Hallelujah. For me. Hallelujah. So I'm not going to die here.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. They were mixed up.
Yeah.
You brought us here to die. They were not looking back at the blood stained. They were not thinking back to what happened that day when the Lord put the blood. Had you put the blood on the doorpost? Are you with me? That's called Passover. God said you're going to have one every year. You're going to take blood every year. And you're going to come to me with the blood every year. Because I want you to look back and remember, I instituted the Passover. I started the Passover.
Yes.
And instead of saying we're going to die here, we're going to say somebody died for me there. Yes. So that I won't have to die here. Are you with me?
Yeah.
He bore my cancer there. I don't have to have it here. He bore my sicknesses there. I don't have to have it here.
Come on.
He bore my penalty there. I don't have to have it here. You didn't bring me here to fail. You didn't bring me here to die. You didn't bring me here to fall apart. You didn't bring me here to have another breakdown. You didn't bring me here to struggle. You brought me here because you did that 2,000 years. Before I preach any farther, which I'm almost out of time. Thank God we're in New Mexico today, and it's an hour earlier. Amen. Hallelujah. I've told this story before about Brother D.P. Holloway, pastors out in East Texas. He had a woman in his church named Sister Jones. D.P. Holloway was the pastor. D.P. Holloway would have a testimony service every Wednesday night. Every Wednesday night, Sister Jones would get up and say, she had cancer all over her face. She would get up and say with that cancer all over her face, I thank God that 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ paid the price, I'm healed. Hallelujah. Cancer growing bigger, but she kept saying, I thank God. 2,000 years ago, somebody died there. So I don't have to die.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Somebody bore this there, so I don't have to bear it now. Anybody going to have some
children? Hallelujah.
Somebody in this place, amen? 2,000 years ago, cancer got bigger. All of a sudden, the board met one night. Oh, God help them boards.
Yeah.
They're pretty boring, I'll be honest with you. The board told Brother Holloway, you need to talk to Sister Jones. We're growing now. You need to tell her to be quiet. You need to tell her to sit down and shut up. She's embarrassing the church by getting up every Wednesday and saying, 2,000 years ago, Jesus Christ paid the price, I'm healed.
Yeah.
Have you with me,
say
amen? It grieved Brother D.P. Holloway. So he went home that after that board meeting, and he said, Lord, what should I do? And the Lord said to him, son, did you die for her? He said, no. Son, are you her Lord? He said, no. Son, are you her Savior? He said, no. He said, then you shut up and leave her alone. Anybody want to say amen?
Amen.
Anybody that you got out there that you need the Lord to tell them, shut up and leave them alone.
Amen.
Thought there'd be a big old shout out there. I put it down in my notes. I'd have to be quiet for 10 minutes getting through the praise. How you love me, say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So Brother Holloway kept quiet. And she got up every Wednesday night and said, I thank God that 2,000 years ago, 2,000 years ago, you didn't bring me here to die. Somebody already died for me. You didn't bring me here to die. You didn't bring me here to fail. You didn't bring me out here to fall apart. Somebody already did that for me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One Sunday morning, she got up and looked at the mirror. Here's what she said. Lord, I know I'm healed, and you know I'm healed. I want to thank you. Oh, you don't know how to say it. You got to say it like a Pentecostal woman. Thank you. Thank you. Anybody got a
thank you?
Thank you. You got to bring it up from your belly. You got to bring it up from your heart. You got to bring it up from the promises of God.
Yeah.
You got to bring it up from those stripes.
Yeah.
You got to bring it up from the anointing.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for
thank you.
It's a redemptive thank you. It's a blood bought thank you.
Yeah.
It's a know that you know that you know that you know that you're sure that you're sure. It's a thank you by faith and not by sight.
Hallelujah.
It's a thank you by faith.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Thank you. I didn't know how to spell it, but I know how to say it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And all of a sudden, that cancer slipped off her face and fell to the floor.
Hallelujah.
You know, I love you. she goes to church that Sunday morning, sits in the same pew, sits in the same place she'd been sitting for years. Brother Holloway comes in, walks right up to her and says, "Ma'am, we sure are glad to have you today as a visitor in our church. What's your name?" She says, "Brother Holloway, don't you recognize me? It's Sister Jones."
Yeah.
He can't believe it. He's startled. He says, "Sister Jones, when did you get your healing?" She says,
2,000 years ago. Hallelujah. 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 2,000 years ago. Glory. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. That's what you got to do. You got to quit saying, "You brought me here to die. You look what I'm going for." No, I've got to look back to one thing, not my past, what Jesus did for me before I had a past.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Give the Lord, can I wake up that baby? Give the Lord a shout of praise.
Hallelujah.
You brought us out here to die. They should have said, "Wait a minute, a lamb died for us."
Yeah.
Said it would be a lamb died for us.
Yeah.
It's the innocent for the guilty. Yeah. You've got to be angry. You've got to bring it into your mind. Bring it into your thinking. Yeah. Jesus paid for that. Yeah. Jesus paid it all. All to Him I owe. All to Him I owe. Say it with me. All to Him
I owe.
Glory to God. You owe it to Him to say it out of your mouth. To quit blaming Him. To quit blaming God. Hallelujah to God. To quit looking at the problem and say, "Wait a minute. You didn't bring me here to die. I'm going to get through this because you have already died. You rose from the dead. I'm more than a conqueror through Him that loves you."
So,
yeah. When you got saved, you put on the garments of salvation. You put on robes of righteousness.
Yes.
You're ready to move forward. You're not ready to stay in that. You're not ready to go backwards into that old habit. Quit it. Quit going backwards. Quit it. Quit taking up that stuff again. Quit it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
Amen.
God equipped you with the move forward. The children of Israel stood there with their clothes, their attire, everything that they had on that day when they had left Egypt's bondage. Everything they had on, every bit of clothing they had on, God said, "Put this on so you can keep moving forward."
Yes.
Moses told him to stand still. God said, "Don't say that. Get up and get
moving." Hallelujah. Get up and get moving.
I want you to turn with me in your Bibles to the book of Psalms. I want to show you something. Psalm 78:42. I know that the devil will try to make you forget.
Yeah, he will. Yeah, he will.
Have you with me? Say amen.
Amen.
The devil will try to make you forget. They remember not his hand, nor the day. Everybody say, nor the day.
Amen.
They will nor the day when he delivered them from the enemy.
Amen.
They were standing at the Red Sea. Here came their enemy, and they did not remember the day that God delivered them.
Wow. They didn't remember the day.
They did not remember. They had already forgotten in just a few hours. They'd already forgotten it just in a few hours. They already forgotten it. You cannot forget the day. There was a day in the annals of time that for 6 hours on a hill not very far away stood the Hallelujah. Son of Man, the Son of God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And he became your substitutionary sacrifice.
Yes, he did.
It was for you. He took everything you would ever face.
Yes.
He took everything that you would ever go through.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He took it. He took it. He took it. He took it. And you've got to go back not to your past, but to that one day.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Right. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait just a minute. You didn't bring me out here to go through this. Right. Hallelujah. I'm going to put my mind back on Calvary's cross.
Yes.
Amen.
And you brought me out here, and I'm going to make it in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Because of what you did that day, that day. Lift your hands up and thank God
thank
for
you, Lord. Thank you for that day.
Thank you
for that day.
Thank you
for that day.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for that day.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for that day.
That's the problem with the church right now. They let go of that day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the problem in a marriage. They let go of that day. That's why people are doing some of the dumbest things. They've let go of the day of visitation.
Yeah.
The day of salvation. The day of deliverance.
Yeah.
Have you with me? Say amen.
Amen.
They don't remember. They don't remember the power. They don't remember what Jesus did that day.
Yeah.
So the devil's got to get your eyes on what you've done.
Yeah. Yeah.
What somebody else has done.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes, that's right. Come on.
What somebody else has done. What a kids of yours has done. What a maid did. What they did down at the job. Your eyes on something instead of your eyes on the day of your salvation.
Yeah.
Yes.
Have you with me? Say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Come up here and stand beside me for a minute, Brother Randy Hines. Would you do it, buddy? How many of y'all love Brother Randy?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brother Randy was speaking and giving communion last Sunday. And he began to read the words in Corinthians from the Apostle Paul. And he said in those words from the Apostle Paul that the Lord had given to the Apostle Paul. The Lord showed the Apostle Paul when the disciples were in the upper room having the communion together.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
He said, I'm going to tell you what was delivered unto me from the Lord. That in the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread.
Yeah.
And that the Lord showed Paul the complete communion service, but he was not there.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Paul was shown the cross, and he wrote about it in Romans, but he was not there.
Yeah.
God showed him the baptism of the Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost, but he was not there.
Yeah. Come on.
What did God do? God reached out and went all the way back to the cross. And God gave him a revelation of it, just like Paul would have been there. This is the thing we don't know about the Lord. That he gave us the mighty power of the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
To get a hold of us and take us back to every drop of blood. Every drop of blood.
Hallelujah.
Every stain, every scar, everything. Come on, somebody.
Amen, amen.
And he shows us again by letting it happen to every one of us. That we get a revelation of it. That's why some of you will go back to an alcohol. You'll go back to an old way. You'll go back to something. Why? Because you have not yet got the revelation of it for yourself. Give Randy a hand clap. Philippians chapter 3 verse 13. Forgetting what's behind you.
Yes.
And reaching to what's before you. And press toward the mark of the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus.
Come on.
The only thing in your past is the cross. The only thing in your past is the blood.
Yes.
The only thing in your past is the baptism of the Holy Ghost coming down on the day of Pentecost. That's what's in your past. And when you reach back to that, and when you look at that, you won't say, I'm out here and I'm dying. I'm out here and I'm giving up. I'm out here and I'm sick. I'm out here and I'm falling apart. I'm out here and it's a mess. Why? Because you won't say it. You won't hold on to that mess. You won't look at it like that. You'll say, wait just a minute.
Yes.
Somebody died for me. Yes. And his name is Jesus.
Yes.
Who do you think you are to live like that? To act like that, to have those secrets when Jesus paid it all.
Yes.
Who do you think you are? You've been bought with a price, you're not your own, and you're on your way to heaven. Clean up your act.
Yes. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Clean up your mind.
Yes.
Quit giving up. Quit giving in. Quit throwing in the towel.
Yes.
Quit stopping.
Yes.
And say, wait just a minute. Jesus Christ paid the price for me.
Yes,
he did. Lord, to heal my eye.
Oh,
give the Lord the praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I've got to finish Hebrews chapter 10. I'm going to finish here. Hebrews chapter 10. Y'all love me?
Amen.
Hallelujah. God's good. Hebrews chapter. Y'all getting something from this?
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
Hebrews chapter 10 verse 1, for the law, having a shadow of good things to come, And not the very image of the things can ever with those sacrifices which they offered year by year continually make the comers thereunto perfect. For then would they have not ceased to be offered, because that the worshiper once were purged should have no more conscience of sin. But in those sacrifices there is a remembrance again made of sins every year. For it is not possible that the blood of bulls and of goats should take away sin.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Did you hear what it said?
Yeah.
Have you heard it?
Yeah. Yeah.
It says under the old covenant there would be a remembrance every year
yeah.
of what you have done wrong.
Yeah. Yeah.
Every year. Yeah.
Every year. Every year.
Amen. Anybody going to help me?
Amen.
How many of you have struggled in your life before with remembrance of past mistakes?
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
That's the old covenant trying to come back into the life.
Yeah.
Yes. Amen.
Because in the old covenant there is always at least a yearly remembrance of your mistakes.
Yeah.
In the old covenant there is remembrance of your failures.
Yes.
Amen.
Anybody going to talk to me?
That's right.
In the old covenant there is a memory of what you've done wrong. So when you have that memory of what you've done wrong, the devil's trying to pull you out of the old covenant, the new covenant, back into the old covenant.
Yeah.
Have you ever felt the devil trying to pull you out of the new back into the old?
Yeah.
When you're walking under the old, it's impossible for the blood of a bull and a goat to take it away. So you'll have a memory of it.
Yes.
A memory of it. Hebrews chapter 9. They're going to shoot it right up there. For if the blood of bulls and goats and the ashes of a heifer sprinkling in the unclean sanctifies the purifying of the flesh. Verse 14. How much more?
How much more?
Shall the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Who through the eternal spirit offered himself without spot to God. Purge your conscience from dead works. To serve the living God.
Hallelujah.
So that blood of a bull and a goat could not purge your conscience, and you would have recollection and memory during the year of your past mistakes.
Yeah.
Past failures that would be like that I am married to you. Can I borrow your sweet wife? If I was married to her, and all of a sudden she did something stupid. I know that she's not capable of it. But we're using our imagination. And what I do is that I remember every bad thing that she has done since I married her. And pull them up to this new mistake that she made.
Come on. Come on.
When I do that, I'm stepping out from under the new covenant and going back into the old.
Yeah.
Because I am remembering mistakes.
Yes.
Yes.
Is anybody going to help
me? Amen.
So it is impossible for me to take a new mistake and pull the old mistakes up and add them to the new mistake if I'm walking in the new covenant. Because in the new covenant, there is no remembrance of past mistakes.
Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Anybody in this place? Amen. So when a divorce starts happening, that couple is moving into the old covenant.
Yeah.
Anybody going to help me with a shout about it?
Hallelujah.
When wars and fussing and fighting, when you feel condemned, the old covenant's trying to take over into your life.
Yeah.
The devil had more freedom in the old covenant. The devil had more liberty in the old covenant. He could walk into heaven in the old covenant and talk to Job. Talk to God about Job. But the new covenant, hallelujah to God, the devil is destroyed. Mama's my failures. I was a bad daddy. I was like this. I did this. I did that. I did this. I did that. I did this. Wait a minute. I wasn't brought out here to die.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm going to get my mind on the substitutionary sacrifice.
Yeah.
I was brought out here to show, look what the Lord has done.
Hallelujah.
Look what the Lord has
done.
Look what he's done. Look what he's done.
And that old stuff, there's remembrance in the new stuff. Jesus said, remember me.
Remember me.
Yes.
Remember me.
He said, this is now your Passover. And every time you eat this and drink it, you don't remember your mistakes. You don't remember your failures. You remember me.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Remember me.
People won't forget what you've done, but the Lord is going to forget what you've done. You need to forget what you've done.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. If you can just get a hold of what I'm preaching today, the only reason that you look back is to look back at what Jesus did.
That's right. Yeah.
And that helps you to move forward. You didn't bring me here to die. You brought me here because somebody else already died for me. And I'm just still moving forward.
Yeah.
How many believe right now you're still just moving forward?
Amen.
How many of you know you might be going through something, but you're moving
forward?
How many know that something might be working against you, but you're
moving forward.
Look at your neighbor and say, I'm moving forward. Because it doesn't matter what the devil's doing, it just matters that you keep moving forward.
Amen.
That's what the Lord said. You tell them, Moses, quit talking to me and tell them to get
moving.
Tell them to get moving. I've stayed still on that cross so that you can get up and
move. Hallelujah.
Lord, stop. Stop it and start moving.
Hallelujah.
Let's give the Lord a praise. Hallelujah. Come here with me today. Say, this is the power of this gospel.
Amen.
This is the power of the new covenant. Come out from under that old covenant today. Come out from under. Don't you let the devil pull you back. The devil's got no freedom in the new covenant. He's got all the freedom he wants in the old covenant.
Yes, yes.
If you're not careful, you go from one to the other, to the other, to the other. I know I'm telling the truth.
Yeah.
You just go back and forth, and then he'll look and see what you're in, the old or the new. And if you're under the old, he'll mess with you. But if you're in the new, there's nothing he can do.
Nothing he can do. Hallelujah. Nothing he can do.
Give the Lord a praise.
Hallelujah.
Look at me. If I'm in guilt right now and I'm saved, I'm under the old covenant.
Yeah.
For there is now, therefore, no condemnation to them.
Amen.
Who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus, the new covenant, has made me free from the old covenant.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've got to stay free, not just of the devil, but the old.
Yeah.
I've got to stay free.
Yes.
It's a covenant of condemnation and judgmentalism. It's a covenant that every year I will remember my mistakes.
Yeah.
But the new covenant is a covenant that I don't have to remember.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
I'm going to ask the fellas to come and begin to pass out the communion.